Hey there, everyone. Welcome to the Mod Golf Podcast video edition on YouTube here. So I've got one of my previous guests and someone who I consider a good friend and an amazing entrepreneur, and that is Elisa Gaudet, who is the founder of Women's Golf Day. So we were just chatting away and catching up on things and decided, you know, why don't we shoot a little video here just to catch up and find out all the great things that Women's Golf Day has done in 2020 and what they're looking to do in 2021 and beyond. So I've got Elisa with me here. So, hey, welcome, Elisa. Good to see you. Thanks for joining me.
Thank you, Colin. Yeah, always nice to see you.
Absolutely. So, hey, give us the update here where you, like so many entrepreneurs, so many businesses, early growth companies and organizations, had everything planned out to roll into your fifth year with Women's Golf Day in June of 2020, and then this little thing called COVID hit. So you could have given up, but you didn't. You kind of pivoted and recalibrated. So tell us what went on in 2020 with Women's Golf Day.
Yeah, absolutely. So I know it was a challenging year. It has been for everybody. We, as always, have our event the first Tuesday in June. And as the situation, it became evident that things were being canceled, we moved our date to September for the actual events. And then the interesting part was, instead of just having that date and then preparing for that, we decided to do a digital day. Especially because we have so many people from around the world, we really thought that this would be an opportunity. And we reached out to our partners, supporters, and sponsors. So that's like the RNA, the USGA, PGA of America, PGA of Canada, and everyone else, and asked them for some video content that fell within our pillars of engaging, empowering, and supporting. And, you know, much to our surprise, I mean, the industry just really took to it and responded. And we now have over 50 videos that were launched on that day in June, our original, what would have been an events day. And now it's part of our video library. And some of our educational, some of our inspiring stories. We have Jen Beljan, you know, architect, female golf course architect, Barbara and Jack Nicholas with Special Message, Michelle Wee, Annika, you know, the cast of characters, Susie Whaley. So it's really good. I encourage everybody to go. And I think for us, that was really making a lemonade out of lemons. You know, it was really hard and our team kept grinding. This is not a space. We weren't a traditional media company or digital company. We used media to have locations register and people find locations, but that was never our platform. We're not really in the content game. So yeah, but you know, we do see now the advantage of that. It was hugely successful. In September, we had 500 locations that were over 500 that were able to have events. We asked them to do it safely, smaller numbers, whatever, and comply with whatever's going on in their geographic location. And all in all, we had 60 million impressions between those 2 days. So we ended up, you know, we worked very hard and we did it, but I think we found a silver lining. We found we made some lemonade, whatever you want to call it. And, you know, I empathize with everybody that's had to do that. And I think, but you do find that in that forced change, and you and I were talking about this, is this great book, Who Moved My Cheese, by Spencer Johnson, which I recommend to anybody if you haven't read it, because it was really like changing for opportunity. And we're have become in an era of forced change. So, you know, you have to embrace it, like, no matter what. We don't have any. Yeah. You don't even have a choice. It's not a choice for optimization. Yeah. Whereas I think the book is more talking about it as it being a choice for optimization. This is, now it's a choice for survival.
Absolutely.
I think that's a huge distinction.
And you and I talked about this earlier, and I've talked to many entrepreneurs in the golf space and also other industry sectors, and also in education. We've seen this too, where so many people have looked at, so many organizations have thought about, oh, this change in this digital transformation and remote working and changing the culture. That's something we'll do in a couple of years, and we're slowly integrating that in. Well, and someone used this phrase on an earlier podcast episode. It's like we've all been shoved in a time machine and propelled forward to 2030 overnight, whether we like it or not, whether we're kicking and screaming or we embrace it, and here we are. So rather than doing these in little steps and slowly transforming our business to digital, virtual, remote platforms, it's like, nope, we've got to do it. And and you have managed to do that. And I'm sure there's been, you know, a lot of pain in order to get there, but I'm very proud of you and your team. The fact you didn't give up, because it is, change is hard, and especially one that's thrust upon you. So let's talk about 2021 now. What are you looking at now that you've created a digital platform and you are there? Mm-hmm. And although you are having kind of in venue also this hybrid, let us know what's in store for Women's Golf Day in 2021.
Yeah, we have our date. Yeah, our date is same as the first Tuesday in June. So it's actually June 1st, 2021. And we'll do a conference a couple days before that, a summit. And it'll be digital. If we're able to do that where people could come and participate, we'll do that as well. We'll have more about that as it unfolds. But that is our plan. And so right now we're working towards that. And I think getting more international markets on board is really important to us, like certain markets, and looking to have at the bare minimum our site, little micro sites that are in, whether it be French, Spanish, Japanese, German, you know, a couple of languages that we feel are important that could help, you know, further expand our reach. That is really important to us, even though we all know the bulk of the market is the US and Canada and Europe. But so that is, you know, that's it. And then, you know, one of these things that I think has come out of this too, is looking at, you know, whether it's 2021 and beyond, but, you know, that influence, this was an interesting thing, comes when we affect change and we turn, you know, some of our as leaders, our ideas into action. You know, a lot of stuff, we can see a lot of stuff that either happens or talked about or programs, but it really is that action, that actionable. And I think that's what made Women's Golf Day different. It wasn't like, hey, go out. It was an actionable plan as to how to engage more women that was well thought out. And I do think that, you know, our job as leaders is to harness that power and inspire that action onto others. And it doesn't necessarily mean going down the chain. It can also be up the chain. And, you know, just by what we do, it does inspire others. We don't know who's watching or whatever. And it could be a bigger organization. And we have to find these ways to outmaneuver, you know, outmaneuver uncertainty. And this is such a cliche thing, but I love it. Yeah, we have to course correct, you know, course correcting. I mean, it's used in business, but, you know, it's used in golf too, right? You know, as these circumstances change and look at ways to strengthen our team, I found that out with what we were doing. You know, how can I strengthen our team and give them the ability, and this is what I thought was interesting, to sense and respond. Because we're almost working off of our senses. Because this isn't like there's a manual to this and how does it go forward. I mean, it's what do we sense? What are our feelings? You know, things like that. It actually comes more into play now than just taking data and spewing it around and then figuring out some type of plan correlating to that data. So same, being able to pivot, you know, find these angles and ways of working and our ability to, you know, react quickly and change. That's our new normal.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's our 2021 plan right there. And that little nutshell is, so I mean, as much as I'm going to say the best, you know, we have our goal, we have our things, but we're going to continue. Like we can't take our foot off the pedal of this, of pivoting, reacting, responding, feeling, and listening, you know, to our team, and especially to, you know, it was very interesting. I mean, I was on the phone all the time with people all around the world. So Dubai, you know, and as things are changing and every country's got a different, you know, if we haven't learned anything, you know, of course, embrace technology, but you're already there. Us, it's a little more of an uphill thing.
I know you're embracing technology, maybe begrudgingly, I guess the best way to put it there, but you're also surrounding yourself around a team that can propel you forward with that. And you're like me, you don't have to be a technology-based founder in order to be successful in a technology-led company now, which Women's Golf Day has now transformed its way or itself into. And that's okay, because you've got so many other attributes.
You just gotta hire good people. Every entrepreneur, you gotta learn that. If you haven't learned that, like, you're dead in the water, I feel like. You 100%. Know, be honest with what your weakness is, or, you know, where, and hire the best people you can afford to hire. 110%.
Yeah, and one thing I really admire about you, well, all those characteristics that you embody as an entrepreneur is not only that tenacity, but also that curiosity and that empathy and the fact you talked about this, you reach out and you listen to people and you ask them and find out what is it that you need? You know, how can we add value here rather than just trying to force your product or your service or your experience on people and hopefully that it resonates. So love that. That's a great entrepreneurial tip for everyone out there that you continue to embrace and embody. So hey, why don't we leave it at this? Because I really want to encourage people, all of our viewers here, to go back, and I'll put it in the show notes below here. Also the links to your YouTube channel and also to Women's Golf Day, so people can find out more about that for 2021 and happening in June. And also we've recorded two previous podcast episodes on the Mod Golf Podcast, where you and I had a great conversation when we first met a couple of years ago. But that conversation still is relevant today. So I will encourage people to go back and listen to that one. I also had a fun one last year or 2 years ago where I went to an event and covered it live, which was awesome. Interesting and fun.
Love it.
So we've got that on there too also. So lots of great stuff happening.
Great.
Elisa, it's good to see you again. Thanks for jumping on this call and joining us on Mod Golf.
And we greatly appreciate your support and for spreading the word. That's what helps us grow. And you are my brother from the north.
Thanks. Appreciate that.
All right, I wish you all the best.
Take care.
Okay, see you soon.